Mr. Jan wants his son to learn a trade. He went to church to pray. The person in charge of the church and number 39's sacrifices stood behind the altar. Hearing the prayers, he whispered, "Learn to steal, learn to steal." When he got home, Mr. Jan told his son to learn to be a thief. Then father and son went to find a teacher to study. It took a whole day to reach that deserted field. In the middle of the forest there was a small house. An old woman was sitting in the house. Mr. Jan asks, "Could you please tell me where the thief teacher and number 39's house is?" The old woman replied, "You can learn that profession here. My son is also a talented person in that profession." Mr. Jan told his son to try to learn the profession that the saint had inspired. The vocational teacher said to Mr. Jan, "I will teach your son to become a profession. 1 year later, please come here. If you recognize your son, I will not take any money. Otherwise you must pay me 200 thalers." Then the father returned to the village. The child stayed to learn a trade. It and number 39's been a year. Mr. Jan set off, thinking thoughtfully as he walked, trying to find a way to receive his child. While he was thinking, a little man came and asked, "What are you thinking about?" Mr. Jan replied, "Oh my God, a year ago I sent my son to learn the thief trade. The teacher who taught him said that after a year, if I recognized him, I would not take the money to teach him, otherwise I would have to pay 200 thalers. I and number 39 am very worried. I don and number 39 know if I will recognize my child again, otherwise I will be very gay. Where will I get the money to pay?" The little man told him to bring bread and stand next to the fireplace when he arrived. The little man also said, "There is a basket in the rafters. If the bird in its shell looks out, then it is your son." Arriving at the vocational teacher and number 39's house, Mr. Jan placed a few pieces of black bread in front of the basket. The bird in the basket stuck its head out. Mr. Jan immediately called out, "Hello, dear son, are you in there?" The bird flapped its wings happily when its father recognized it. The vocational teacher said angrily, "Only the devil could whisper to him and he would know." The son said, "Father and I, let and number 39's go home." Then father and son set off home. Along the way, they met a horse-drawn carriage passing by. The son said, "I will turn into a hunting dog. Dad will sell it and have a lot of money to spend." The father waved to hail the car and said, "Hey, do you want to buy a dog?" The coachman asks, "How much will you sell?" 30 thalers. "Oh my! That and number 39's expensive. Fine, give me the dog." The coachman put the dog in the cart and continued his journey. The car had only gone a short distance when the dog jumped out of the car and rushed straight into the forest, running back to where his father was standing. Another time, on the day of the market, the son said to his father, "Today I will turn into a horse." "Dad brought the horse to the market to sell, and after the sale, I will return to my human form." The father took the horse to the market to sell. The founder of the thief profession went to the market, saw a beautiful horse, bought it and paid 100 thalers. The buyer takes the horse home and puts the horse in the stable. Seeing the maid pass by, the horse said, "Open the stable door for me, open the stable door for me." The girl opened the barn door again, and the horse immediately turned into a sparrow and soared across the roof. The homeowner was also a magician, so he immediately turned into a sparrow and flew after him. A moment later, they caught up. The two birds challenged each other. The thief master turned into a fish swimming underwater, the student also turned into a fish, and the two sides challenged each other again. The thief turned into a rooster, the boy turned into a fox and jumped and bit the chicken and number 39's neck in half. The chicken fell dead and is still lying there to this day. Thank you for joining us for today's fairy tale. We hope these stories bring joy and meaning to your day. If you love our channel, please hit the subscribe button so you won't miss any exciting tales. Wishing you a good night and sweet dreams. See you in the next story.